Hey everybody, Adam Savage here in my cave with another one day build, another chapter in the ongoing saga of me making my own Samaritan, Hellboy's famous sidearm. And I realized early in the process, if I was going to be building the Samaritan, I also had to take the time to make the Samaritan's bullets. And by the way, these are not real bullets, they are bullet-shaped objects. But I'm going to talk about them as if they're real bullets. They are composed of two components, the brass casing and the aluminum, polished aluminum bullet part. The brass casing, pretty much stuff I've done 100 times on the lathe. But maintaining a consistent curvature on the bullet part, that involved bringing in some technology that I am not super familiar with, and I'm pretty happy with the results. But that's what this video is about, so here we go. We are living the dream of the one day builds right now. I'm in the process of making myself a 1-to-1 scale Hellboy Samaritan, all out of aluminum. And while this build continues apace, it is time to take a look at making some Samaritan bullets. That's where I'm looking. Hi. Making some Samaritan bullets. This is one of the giant 22 millimeter bullets that gets loaded into the Samaritan. And I wanna make some. So, this is a really nice one. This came with the Hero version of the gun. This is one of the replicas that I have here. And I'm gonna use this as my basic jumping off point. Now there's two parts to this bullet, obviously. A back half, which I'm going to machine in brass, and a front half, which I'm going to machine in aluminum. Now, how do you get, there we go. So how do you get a regular, repeatable shape like this bullet shape? The answer is you make your own lathe tool to do it. And that is the first step of making some Samaritan bullets. So I'm over here at my lathe tooling set of drawers, and I've pulled out a high-speed steel blank. This is a blank lathe tool, and it is out of this that I am going to carve mine. I'm gonna walk you through the process. I am not an expert at this process. I am trying, actually, while I have modified high-speed steel lathe tools on a grinder, I have never made one from scratch, so this is a first for me. Yeah, here's how we go. Here is a Hero bullet from one of the licensed replicas, and I have cut it in half, and I've cut it in half so that I may understand its profile. And I'm going to trace its profile, actually first in Sharpie, there we go. And so this'll just help you understand what I'm about to do and how it's gonna go. So, here is the shape. Now what's gonna happen is I'm going to grind out everything that's colored in, I'm grinding out. So I'll end up with a kind of a gentle curve that hopefully, as I bring a piece of aluminum into the lathe, it cuts the profile of that piece of aluminum down to this curve. That's the theory. In practice, the way I'm gonna do it is I'm gonna use a bit of Dicom, some blue marking fluid, and I am going to, I'm doing that top. There we go. So I'm just going to be painting the top of this so that I have a canvas to draw on. It survives under much higher heat than a Sharpie does. Let me just dry this off. I've got a scribe, so when I make a mark on my marking fluid, I'll see it very clearly, and I'll see it in high detail even when I'm grinding. So I'm gonna be putting this on here, starting from the center. And again, there will be multiple passes on this grind. I'm not gonna try and get it perfect on the first try because you never do. However, it always makes sense when you're doing layout or drawing stuff that you're going to cut to actually color in what you're cutting and what side of the line you're cutting on. I can't stress that enough, how easily you can forget.
So now I have the design that I'm grinding drawn out on this piece of tool steel, and I'm going to start to grind it. It's gonna spin for a while. Full disclosure, I thought I had put a time lapse on and I had not. So I'm sorry I don't have footage of this, but here is where my grinding tool currently stands. Now, when you're grinding high-speed steel, you don't want to get it too hot because you don't want to change the metallurgical properties of the steel, so it's really good to have a bucket of water around, as I've had. So you grind a little bit, cool it back down. Grind a little bit, cool it back down. If it starts to turn a straw color, you're changing the steel's properties, and you don't want to do that. I'm pretty happy with where we are on this, so I think the next step is to attempt to see how it works on a piece of aluminum. Yeah, I'm gonna chuck this into my lathe and see if this isn't just a nice metal-shaped object, but might actually do some work for us. We'll see.
First step is cutting the aluminum down to the correct size. So here is my completed bullet blank. It's the correct size, and I am now going to swap out my cutoff tool for my profile tool, and I'm pretty happy with how it looks right now. Now, because I'm removing more and more material as the profile peels away, it's getting warm, so I'm gonna make sure to add a lot of cooling fluid. I'm pleased with the rough shape the profile has given me. Now it's time to use sandpaper to finesse it. Now I'm really pleased with how this is looking so far. But wait till you see what steel wool can do for aluminum. It's awesome. So I'm really pleased at this point with how this first test is going. I'm pleased with the profile tool, how it cuts. It's time to cut this off the stem and move on to making the brass casing. Now the bottom of the bullet has a lip on it that's got a very square edge on the casing, and I want it to have a round edge. I certainly could finesse that round edge with a flat file, but I found one that's much better. It's got a concavity to it. It's made for guitar frets, and it's perfect for rounding the base of my bullet. Look, the audio on this part was shite, so I'll just explain what's happening. I'm going to push this tool here into the brass, but in order not to destroy it, I will use this piece of steel behind it to give myself something to push against. Look, this is better, it's decent, it's not great, I'll admit that, but it's a learning process. That's why I'm doing it this way, so that I can figure it out. I'm confident that I'll get to a place I'm very satisfied with. Well, ta-da, it's finished. It could be better, but it's a great first test. Now I need to work on my crimp and get the primers cut in, and, well, I need to figure out how the lettering's gonna work on the bottom. So at this point in the construction, I had 20 plus bullets that I was satisfied, casings that I was happy with, and they press fit together just perfectly, but I still didn't have the lettering on the bottom of my bullets. And I went through a lot of different iterations about how to do this. I considered lining them up on a template and having them laser etched, but I've never loved the lack of depth in laser etching metal. I considered doing it as a vinyl transfer and acid etching, but I was playing around recently with some ferric chloride in brass, and it takes a long time, and frankly, I didn't feel confident I would end up with the crisp lettering I wanted. And here comes my friend Victor Broadley to the rescue. He's a machinist down in Southern California, and he has this old piece of equipment, which is an old toolmaker's mill. And a toolmaker, when I say that, I'm describing someone who makes giant steel blocks with cavities in them for injection molding toys and tools and stuff like that. Toolmakers are the Albert Einsteins of machining, man. They blow my mind with the things they could do. And Victor has an old toolmaker's mill, which can take a stylus and read a three-dimensional pattern and transfer that to a three-dimensional carving on another part of the mill. So he was able to set up some letters over on one part and then etch those letters at any scale he wanted onto the base of my bullet. Also, I didn't realize that Victor would do this. He also laid the primers into the center of the bullets. I didn't think he was gonna do that. I thought I was gonna do that when they got back here. So I was super psyched. have to admit, when I first thought of making the bullets as a separate video, I thought, oh, this will be a quick one. I didn't realize it would take over 2 weeks and another several days of my time, but I could not be happier. These bullets look great. They feel like correct objects. It's always the experience that I'm looking for. And I also, it's not enough that Victor broadly succeeded in doing perfect etching for me on the bottom of my bullets. He also took the opportunity to show off a little bit, and he sent me some of his version of Hellboy's clear bullets with silver and oak inside a liquid. And frankly, the showing off was achieved because I'm not convinced I know exactly how he made these. These blow my mind with their precision and their beauty. Thank you, Victor. Thanks you guys for watching, and as always, I will see you next time. Adam Savage here in my cave with a thank you to everyone who has joined the tested channel memberships thus far. It truly allows us to keep up this high level pace of video production, and frankly, it energizes us a lot to talk to you guys. In that vein, I have also loved diving back in to doing the live stream. Specifically, tested member questions have been phenomenal. And other tested family members are going to be doing their own live stream soon. Keep an eye on this space to find out when and where. And we have also heard your feedback, and we've decided to add a new membership tier at $4.99 a month that is comparable to the tested premium membership package we used to have. Members at that level will get all the supporter level perks, and in addition to that, they'll get access to our premium video archive, behind the scenes updates, and members only vids. Of course, tested patrons still get the most access to me and the team. They get build diaries, first dibs in the Q&A, and influence in future builds that you'd like to see us make. So we hope you'll click join and find out more about tested membership levels, and we truly hope you will actually join. Thanks, guys. I'll see you next time.